I don't know if you're talking to me or not. All I got is static.
Okay, well, I got to figure out how to get this big Andrew antenna down. 20 feet high. And Frank's down there. Wave hello, Frank, to the camera. That's Frank. He's on the ground. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to loosen this and try and slide it down. But I have to get it past this tower. So I have to loosen them both, slide it down a little bit, take this one off. So that way the whole thing can be... Okay, still recording. Incidentally, the first time I took one of these antennas down, this is where I got my gin pole clamps from. You can see them. Hey, Frank. I can't hear you.
Hello. I don't know if you're talking to me or not. All I got is static.
I don't want to loosen this any more than I need to. I may have to tighten it up again in a hurry, so it's really not very heavy. It's just awkward. This thing's 20 feet tall, man. Okay, here we go. Trying to get my cutters out of my bag. That's why you guys are watching the cars drive by. In case you guys anytime need some land clearing when you're in Belleview, contact RBI. Contact Kathy at RBI. Tell her I said hi. Ooh. Okay, I got the thing secured and it's down pretty far. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook it off to the rope and I'm going to make the decision whether or not I'm going to throw it all the way down there to Frank or if I'm going to let it off on the rope. So, here we go. Okay, the antenna's loose.
I'm ready.
Hey, you can get out of the way. I'm gonna toss it. Okay, here we go. That stood up. Bullseye. Okay, now that that's over, get the gin pole up here and start getting this tower down. Well, Frank is sending up the rest of the tools to get the tower down, and while he's doing that, I just thought I'd tell you, there's a FedEx truck right there. You guys see that? That's a FedEx truck, in case you guys wonder. There's a white car right there with a sunroof or a moonroof. There's a couple signs. I'm up about 125 feet right now. And whatever comes down from this tower is going to Hernando Broadband in Hernando County, Florida. All right, everything's coming up now. You guys have to wait a minute while this stuff comes up. Frank's been helping me out for a little while. He got a wife and he's got two dogs and two cats. So the cats and the dogs eat good. We're trying to feed Gloria today. Now Gloria's really cool. They moved out here from Texas. And I put up a 50-foot antenna tower for him for Al's TV in Dunellen. And Andy Arevalo, he's been around a long time. His dad owned the business for a very long time. Oops! Okay, you can relax. Well, that guy wire's sitting in the way, so well, we're not gonna cry about it. I usually spin the thing around and set it in place, but it'll be all right. My wife's watching right now somewhere. I just want to say hi to Heather, my baby. Woman's a gift from God, man, in case you guys are wondering. Put it there in case that weld breaks. At least it's still got that one rung to hold on to. I'm just gonna get this one section down and then get you guys back over to the world. This tool, but every time you hit the button, man, it smells like electrical. I just want Ryobi to know that I like it, but every time I hit the button, it smells like electrical. Other than that, it makes my job pretty easy. I'll tell you what, I broke these bolts loose by hand for a long time, and I'll tell you what, I wasn't happy about it for a long time. I used to cut myself and, you know, spend half, you know, twice as much time getting these things off, three times as much time, but, hey man, technology is good for one reason, they make your life easier, but they make you lazy too. I guess I'm admitting that I'm lazy. That's fine. I like to do things the easy way. If that makes me lazy, then hey. That just makes you... I don't know what that makes you. just want to say hi to Paul up there in Athens, Georgia. He just bought himself a climbing belt. He's got a low power radio station. And he got the climbing bug. Dude, I told him to be careful. That's all I told him. Figure out what works the best for you, Paul. I can't tell if that's bad advice or not. I don't know. He's still alive. As far as I know. I think Frank heard from him the other day. Or something. I don't know. He sent him some copy for his radio station. Gotta be real careful. I don't drop nothing. And it's funny that I'm talking about it, but I just don't want to drop anything on Kathy's roof. She's got a metal roof. There goes a white Mustang, a convertible. John Kay's Mustang is silver. I don't know if it's a convertible or not. He locked himself out of the car one day. I had to drive him home. Okay. I'm gonna get this jack in place. Get a hold of Frank. Hold on a second. Hey, Frank.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you go ahead and get on the rope. I'm about to send this section down. Just give me a little slack, Frank. Ben's a good guy, but he just believes that the world is flat. You know, what am I going to tell the guy? So I also thank God for what's going on in my life and everything. Just don't want everybody to forget that. Okay, hold on a sec. Go ahead and hold the rope, but just give me a second. You do that with your Rohn tower jack. Jesus. Decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. Hook that off, watch this. Come on, get on. There we go. Okay, that's hanging. That's where it's hanging for now. So, I gotta get my gloves on and get this thing down.